Hello.
Oh. Well, thank you for coming, everybody. This is the bell choir from First United Methodist Church and directed by James Black, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Choir from Midland First United Methodist Church. It is a pleasure to be here. That was a piece we just played on Easter Sunday with organ and bells. It is a setting of the Grand Choir Dialogue by a French composer whose name is escaping me at the moment, Gigout, something to that effect, combined with Lead On, O King Eternal, the hymn tune that you might have recognized. So we are so glad to be here with you today. We have a varied program of some sacred choices and some secular choices because we thought it would be fun to do something a little fun. So if you can pause for 1 second. So up next we have a piece called The Rainbow Connection, which you might recognize from the Kermit the Frog, from the movie, what's the name of the movie?
The Muppet movie. I was curious, is there anyone here who this is their first time to ever hear handbells played in person? I'm not seeing anyone. So you've all heard bells played before. Does anybody know what handbells are made of? What kind of metal? Anyone want to venture a guess? Anybody?
Beeswax.
Not brass, but that's a very good guess. Any other thoughts? So handbells are actually made of bronze, or at least these handbells are made of bronze, which is an alloy of copper and tin. And our bass bells down here that are silver looking are actually made of aluminum. And they make the lower bells much lighter. The aluminum is much lighter than if you were to make it out of bronze. So that's why those are made out of aluminum. And bell choirs are often ranked according to their ability into copper, tin, and bronze, with coppers being the beginners and tins being intermediates and bronze being more advanced. This happens to be a bronze choir, so they play some of the harder, more difficult literature in the handbell world. But the piece we have coming up next for you is by a contemporary Christian artist named Laura Story, and she wrote a song called Blessings, and I believe it was released in 2011 and was a pretty large hit in the contemporary Christian music world. And basically, if you don't know the song, it's a song about that talks about what if the heartaches in life are really God's blessings in disguise.
Thank you.
piece coming up next almost needs no introduction, but I will go ahead and introduce it anyway. This is a piano and handbell setting of Amazing Grace. Next piece is called The Good Old Summertime, and it is a medley of different songs, including In the Good Old Summertime, After the Ball, The Band Played On, Daisy Bell, and I believe that's it.
Is that the last one?
I think it's the last one. So it's a medley of all of those tunes that I'm assuming that many of you might know and recognize. The Good Old Summertime. And I'm wearing my pineapple shirt in honor of spring and summer. One more piece for you for us to play today, and I was actually surprised. There's a few people in my choir. I grew up singing this in church, and I just thought it was clearly universal for all time. But if I were a butterfly, does anyone know? If I were a butterfly, I thank the Lord for giving me wings. I feel like I need to sing the whole thing for. but I just thank you, Father, for making me me. Is the song that we're going to be closing with, the butterfly song. It's a children's Sunday school song. And it's how we're going to finish our season this May in church. So if you attend at First United Methodist Church, just pretend that this is the first time you're hearing it, and then in May you'll hear it the first time again. Anyway, the butterfly song. Thank you.
Today. I hope you have a wonderful spring and a beautiful rest of your day.
Thank you.
And if you would like to come up and look or ask questions, feel free to do that as well.
Thank you.